announcing via Twitter that he is skipping the time-honored White House Correspondents' Dinner, an event that started all the way back in 1920. President Trump tweeting earlier, "I will not be attending the White House Correspondents' Association dinner this year. Please wish everyone well and have a great evening." Mr. Trump will be the first president to miss the dinner in more than 35 years. The last was President Reagan, who skipped in 1981 while he was recovering after being shot. Reagan still called in by phone, however, and I want to talk about what this means for an already contentious relationship between the press and the White House. With me now is economist Ben Stein. He served as a speechwriter and a lawyer for President Richard Nixon. He also worked on the other side as a journalist. Ben, I suppose you are not particularly surprised by this development.
I'm not surprised at it. I'm not disappointed at it. And I don't blame Mr. Trump one bit for doing it. I mean, he's a punching bag day after day after day in the media, especially what's called the mainstream media. And I don't blame him for not wanting to go and be a punching bag in person.
Okay, so did you hear what he said yesterday at CPAC where he's talking about the media?
I saw some of it actually on CNN as you were excerpting it. Yes, I had that pleasure.
So he said that he called the media the enemy of the people, which is what we heard him say before on Twitter. So he said that out loud. He accused the media of making things up, of making up sources.
Is that
something you would give credence to, or what is going on there with what he's saying?
Well, I wouldn't say that all of the media is the enemy of the people, but look, every day you pick up the New York Times, every day they're slamming him. I'm a great fan of CNN. I watch it quite faithfully. Every day CNN is slamming him. Every day they're looking for a scandal. They're just turning the woods upside down looking for a scandal. They're hoping, I think, to do to him what they did to Nixon a long time ago. And I still haven't found any real scandals. And I, with all due respect, I don't blame him for being furious at them. And I think he's got a lot of company. I'm out there giving speeches all around the country all the time. Awful lot of people are not great fans of the media, and they see the media as an unelected aristocracy and effete corps of impudent snobs, as Vice President Agnew called them a long time ago, who are dumping all over the mainstream of America. And I think Mr. Trump has a lot of company.
Do you think some of what goes on is self-inflicted by Mr. Trump?
Mr. Trump is not the smoothest operator. I mean, he's not Bob Hope. He's thin-skinned, and he fires right back. I agree. There's no doubt some of it is self-inflicted. But I think this general idea that the press can just hack away at the president, that he is expected to just sit there and take it, is not a sound idea. And I've noticed day after day, week after week, everything's negative. Not one positive response. I mean, here's a guy who picked a person generally among the legal profession, and I am a lawyer as well known, awful lot of lawyers, very well-respected guy as the Supreme Court Justice, we hope, and hardly any positive coverage of that. He is doing what his constituents ask him to do.
May I counter that, Ben?
Because please, of course, that's
when,
why you're
when
there.
When Gorsuch went up and spoke to a Democratic senator, we covered in depth the fact that Gorsuch had said something that actually endeared him to Democrats, and that actually a lot of establishment Republicans appreciated, and it actually, many people thought, tempered Gorsuch, or at least revealed him as they felt to be a moderate that they think he is. I mean, how are we covering this in a negative way, maybe a nuanced way? Or Donald Trump goes to the African American History Museum and he talks about countering bigotry, and we cover that as well.
You did cover that. So that's one or two of hundreds of stories, most of which are extremely negative. And God bless you for doing that positive stuff. But look at the way they slammed him for not covering right immediately the desecration of the Jewish cemetery outside St. Louis. I mean, this is a guy, and look at the way the media is endlessly playing him up as an anti-Semite. This is a guy who has a Jewish son-in-law, whose own daughter converted to Judaism, who's never been quoted saying a single anti-Semitic word, and they're constantly slamming him as being a racist or a white supremacist or something without any evidence of it at all. I think, with the greatest respect, and I appreciate your pointing out things where I was mistaken, But with the greatest respect, this is a guy that they're just smearing all the time. I don't blame him for wanting to fire back at them. If he were as smooth as Ronald Reagan, he would handle it more smoothly. But no one, again, will ever be as smooth as Ronald Reagan.
You said you think the press is trying to do to him what they did to Richard Nixon.
Yes.
So give us your perspective on that, because a lot of people look at what happened to Richard Nixon and they say, I mean, what Richard Nixon did to himself. The tapes from the Oval Office showed that 6 days after the Watergate break-in, he was discussing himself. He was discussing a cover-up, you know, the smoking gun tape. How did the media do that to Richard Nixon?
The media picked one tiny little thing that he did. One tiny little thing he did, which is just to discuss a cover-up. He didn't do the cover-up. They didn't follow through with the cover-up payments that he discussed. They just discussed it. This was a guy who brought more peace to the world than any president in the 20th century. Open relations with China. First strategic arms limitation talks with the Soviet Union and leading to an agreement. Ended the war in Vietnam. Brought home the prisoners of war. Saved the life of the state of Israel. And so,
so you think the Watergate scandal and what was uncovered was phooey?
It was not a good thing. Shouldn't have done it, obviously. But compared with his achievements, nothing. And I think they're doing the exact same thing to Mr. Trump, whose achievements, by the way, compared with Nixon, are nil. But I think they're trying to do the same thing. They're trying to undo him, basically, before he even gets started. I mean, I think it's just extremely unfortunate. The country has real problems. And for them to be focusing on trying to bring down this guy before he's even gotten started is a serious mistake. We have real problems.
Focus Europe. The Chinese red. 1990.